By this point, most of you already know that I have a 5.9 kilowatt hour solar system on the roof of my house. Scratch that, not kilowatt hour, kilowatts. It generates kilowatt hours worth of electricity. And actually, I just hit my first megawatt a couple days ago. Awesome. So the question I have been getting from a lot of my viewers after posting my first solar system tour video, which was filmed when it was really freaking cold out, was, have my electric car charging habits changed at all? Well, yes, considerably. Let's first go back to what most people will have if they have electric cars, and that would be time of use metering plans. That's where on peak during the daytime on weekdays, your rates are going to be higher, but then off peak when electric demand is at its lowest, and also which would also cover nights or be nights and weekends, when there's overproduction of power, which would otherwise be wasted, the utility gives you a cheaper rate, which is basically an incentive to use the power that would otherwise have been wasted. Well, the utility is pretty much shooting themselves in the foot at the moment, at least in my case. Now, I do have time of use power, and because of what they're doing, I have actually considerably changed my charging habits. I am no longer charging off-peak. I'll get that to that in a moment. Of course, there's also flat rate billing for electrical service as well. If you have a smaller solar setup that does not quite meet your full power needs, or you do not create enough power to overproduce, chances are you'd actually be better off on a flat rate generation or consumption rate plan. You will probably not get as much power if you do happen to overproduce, you will not get paid as much if you do happen to overproduce. But if you're consuming more than you produce, in the end, you might be a little bit better off if you can manage your power wisely. In my case, here's what we're going to do. We're going to plug the car in right now. Today is a Friday during the daytime. It is 2:35 p.m. And in the past, I would not even fathom plugging the car in before 7 p.m. or letting it charge after 7 a.m. on a weekday. But now, I don't mind. Let's plug in, because I am down to my last 15 miles on the car of rated range. Shazam. And you know what? I still haven't changed my charge timer, so I'm going to go change that. And hopefully the radio doesn't start playing. And we're going to reach right here, start charging. Scheduled charging is enabled for this location. Yes, start charging anyways. I still have it set for 7 p.m. charge start, but that is no longer needed. Now, the reason I wouldn't fathom doing this in the past is in the past I would be paying 19 cents per kilowatt hour to charge my car. But in off-peak, I would have only been paying about 9 cents. Right? Actually, it was 8.9 something, 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 something they have on the bill. So, I'm going to explain why. We're going to go in the garage. I have a piece of cardboard. I'm going to draw it out for you and show you guys the math. And a copy of one of my bills. Now, this is end of April, this month's bill doesn't generate until tomorrow, but I will not be able to do this video for quite a while, and I'm just getting too many people asking me. So I'm actually overproduced in the daytime and the nighttime on this last bill, and that's due to being able to see my first bill on solar and adjust my charging habits and energy usage accordingly. So let's go take a look. Here is a copy of my We Energies bill. Now, it is a very poorly laid out and completely confusing in terms of solar, because they're trying to confuse you in terms of solar production, how much you used, how much you're getting credit for, and how much you're getting paid. It is so confusing that before I even had my solar activated, I tried finding out exactly how the payback works, and the consensus from We Energies and the answer I got was just wait for your first bill and it will be so much easier, because we actually have no flippin' clue how our own billing works for solar. So that's what I did. I waited for my first bill and realized almost instantly I am getting screwed. Now, the most important thing to take from this bill is I overproduced on the daytime, so I have zero daytime charges. I did not overproduce enough off-peak to cover all my off-peak usage, so I have a off-peak use that I did not overproduce of 342 kilowatt hours. So that is what I'm getting charged for. I'm getting charged $30.66 for the 342 kilowatt hour of power that I used that I did not overproduce. Although I did overproduce in general for the 196 kilowatt hours of peak, on-peak overproduction. Yes, this is sounding confusing. Here's the deal. If you didn't watch my last video talking about how the utility is screwing over customers, and this is not just Wisconsin, this is all over. We'll get to that in a moment. So the important number is 342 kilowatt hours of off-peak power that I did not overproduce enough to eliminate. So we'll take that 342 kilowatt hour, which cost me, or I'm being charged $30.66 for. Now for the 196, it's 30.66, good enough. For the 196 kilowatt hour that I overproduced during the daytime, I am getting paid, or in other words, in this case, credited, only $9.03 credit. And I pay. Okay, now this is how the utility used some billing trickery. Now, my original understanding, and the best that the utility was able to explain to me, is that before I would get billed for anything, I would first get all the power subtracted from my production. So that means I shouldn't have even gotten paid yet, or given or credited for the 196 kilowatt hour. That 196 should have been subtracted from the 342 kilowatt hour. Because remember, payback, I'm only getting, this is winter season, so for payback, I am getting 4.608 cents a kilowatt hour. But for off-peak consumption, I have to pay 8.9640 cents a kilowatt hour. So I am getting credited on-peak production half of what I have to pay for off-peak. So obviously, that kind of sucks. So what my understanding was that I would get credited, or all my power would be deducted off of my production before I would have to get billed. So my understanding would be 384 kilowatt hour minus 196 of overproduction would have meant I only would have had 188 kilowatt hours of off-peak to be billed. If that was the case, times 8.964 cents a kilowatt hour, so 188 times 8.964 cents would mean, my math sucks, 342, I screwed up somewhere here, 342 minus 196, 146. 146, okay, I'm sorry, 146, must have hit a wrong button. 146 would have been what I did not produce enough to cover. So 146 times 8.964 cents would have meant, there we go, would have meant my bill should have been $13.09, because it's actually 8744, but we'll just round up. So this is what I thought would happen. I would have only had to pay $13.09, not the $30.66. You see, what they did is they separated off-peak and on-peak production and consumption. So instead of me having to pay this, or this, I had to pay this. And that means $30.66. And then they paid me for the overproduction at a 4.608 cents per kilowatt hour rate. So that means I ended up having to pay out of pocket $20.63. Does that make sense? Does that make sense so far? Are you guys following me? So they used billing trickery and very confusing billing tactics to get an extra $20.63 out of me. God, this is so frustrating. It gets me confused. Okay, 3066 minus 13.09 means they got $17.57 more out of me by billing me in this fashion, instead of subtracting all my usage out of the production first. But now, on the other hand, now, because my system is just enough to basically eliminate my usage, at least during the summer season, I'm definitely going to be producing a ton. During the winter season, I'll probably still be using a bit more than what I'm producing, but at the same time, I'm still going to be producing more during the daytime. So how is this hurting the utility? Well, here is what's happening and why it's hurting the utility. Yes, there's some gas cans there. No, there's not gas in them. They're filled with waste motor oil. The idea is, to help the utility, they should really want me to charge off-peak. Even though my solar system is generating, you know, I could be generating a megawatt of power during the daytime, during the month. But if I'm charging at a higher rate, I mean, the car can charge it up to 20 kilowatt. Whereas my solar system, its absolute max output at any one moment is going to be 5.9. Well, of course, a little fluctuation. But I'll never be able to output more at the same time using it in the car. So that means it's basically like a peak demand kind of thing. The utility wants to avoid peak demands. They want to avoid high spikes in their usage because they're going to have to ramp up additional emergency generation if that peak gets too high, such as in the summertime when you got all these air conditioners going and their generation facilities are maxed out. And then here comes, you know, down the line a little bit, a ton of electric car owners plugging in the middle of the day and charging at full power. They might have a brownout, blackout. It seems to be what might be going on a little bit in California. With all the brownouts, it should be their incentive to have me dump 90 kilowatts of power into my car at night, not during the day. It's that demand, that spike of power draw. So because of this billing trickery, it's actually going to cost me less, or in this case, well, on that last bill, cost me less, because I ended up having to pay $20.63 for that power usage instead of $13.09. It's frustrating. So how could I have gotten away with that? Well, if I would have used more of my power that I generated during the daytime instead of trying to still use my loads off-peak, then I could have wiped that out. Or if I switched my billing for the time being to a flat rate, then it doesn't matter if I generate it at night and use it, or generate it in the day and use it at night. Since I'm on a flat bill, there is no on-peak and off-peak. They're shooting themselves in the foot right now. Yeah, they're getting a few extra cents out of me now. But in the long run, it's going to really hurt them, because now I'm going to switch all my heavy loads to daytime, and use up as much of my overproduction as I can. Now, in the case of once I have my roof maxed out, now all my off-peak generation for solar is pretty much going to be done on weekends and holidays, because that's the only time the sun's going to be out on the off-peak. And I guess I get a little bit in the morning, but extremely little. Before 7 a.m., I only generate maybe 200 or 300 watt hours. After 7 p.m., I might generate 300 or 400 watt hours. There's just not enough sunshine here in Wisconsin at those times on off peak, so it's going to be weekends. But if I have a bigger system, then yeah, this is going to work out just fine, because I'll be producing enough in off peak to cover all the usage. But it really makes no difference. Just use it during the day. Now, once Tesla finally delivers my Founders Edition Powerwall 2, then things are going to change again, because now I can have that Powerwall 2 generate or recharge during the daytime and then dump that power back into the house at night. So I'll basically be using my stored daytime solar power for everything off-peak. And once I got that set up, I can basically forget about time of use altogether. I'll keep it because when I overproduce, I'll get paid more. Or, yeah, I will. I'll get paid more or credited more if I'm cutting it very close on my usage. And I can pretty much use the power any time of the day I want. So I can run that air conditioner full blast during the day if I feel like it. Don't have to worry about having an insane bill. So I hope you're able to follow this a bit and learn a little bit about how tricky these utilities are getting. And it used to be much better, but they lobbied for a 6% increase in rates, and they snuck a whole bunch of stuff into their bills, at least here in Wisconsin, back in 2014, which went into effect January 1st, 2015. A lot of people were caught off guard on that, and it really, really hurts. And for those that managed to get locked into contracts before that change took place, they're raking in a lot of money. They're getting as much as 27 cents per kilowatt hour on peak payment, because they have to get paid whatever, back then, before the change, they would get paid whatever the retail rate was that the customer would have to pay the utility. So at the moment, utilities are kind of double dipping, and it's still great. And that last bill, my bill was still like $100, but that was still a lot of winter gas usage for heating the house. And now that I have this figured out, I'm actually charging during the daytime, and I even took the timer off. I have a deep chest freezer in my downstairs, and that was always on a timer. The coldest possible temperature kicking at 7 p.m., run all night and on weekends, and then just shut off during the daytime when power was at peak, so I got rid of the timer. So basically, I could care less when I use my power now. It's actually given me more freedom having the solar, being able to charge whenever I want, not being stuck to a time of use plan. So if you have any questions, post in the description box below. And if you didn't watch it yet, here's the other side of the cardboard, showing yesterday's video, which if you haven't watched it, the link is coming up. Let's put the link right here, and you can click on that and it'll take you to the other video, the prologue of this bin. So